Are you struggling to expand your business due to financial constraints? Ever wondered how to maximize growth opportunities with limited resources? Do you feel like your business is stuck because of a tight budget? Hi, I'm Mommy and your Mommy Negosyo, and in this video, we're diving into a topic that many entrepreneurs face, how to grow your business even when you have limited funds. Whether you're just starting out or looking to scale, financial limitations should not hold you back. Here are 5 tips we'll explore to help your business thrive without breaking the bank. Number 1, focus on low-cost marketing strategies. Number 2, leverage technology for efficiency. Number 3, build strong relationships and partnerships. Number 4, prioritize customer experience. And number 5, invest in continuous learning and development. Now let's get started with tip number 1. Focus on low-cost marketing strategies. Utilize cost-effective marketing techniques that maximize reach without draining your budget. It allows you to increase brand visibility and attract customers without significant financial investment. Let's use Ella's story for you to know how to do this. Ella owns a handmade jewelry business. She started her jewelry business from home with the money that she saved. And after some time, she realized that she needed to scale her business. But she had one problem. The money she had was not that big. Thankfully, she is a social media buff, meaning to say, she knows how to use social media platforms with ease. And so, with a minimal budget for marketing, Ella used social media platforms to reach a wider audience on a limited budget. She focused on creating eye-catching and engaging content to showcase her unique designs. She even offered special promotions on special occasions like Mother's Day, Valentine's Day, and so on. And as a result of her creative efforts, Ella grew her clientele online. So you see, there are ways right under your nose to help you focus on low-cost marketing strategies. Let's move to tip number 2, which is to leverage technology for efficiency. You don't have a budget for now? No problem. You can use digital tools and platforms to streamline operations and reduce overhead costs. This improves productivity, enhances customer service, and optimizes resource allocation. Here's how. Meet my coaching client, Rina. She's an online business manager with a team. Now, Rina was struggling to manage multiple client projects while keeping her costs down. And to address this concern, she looked for tools to help her manage things without having to hire more staff. After a while, a friend recommended a user-friendly and budget-friendly project management tool. And this helped her keep track of deadlines, communicate better with clients, and make her workflow smoother. And the results were amazing. By using this technology, Rina delivered projects faster and made her clients happier. She was able to take on more projects and grow her freelance business without needing to hire more staff. So, use modern technology to your business's advantage, okay? Let's have tip number 3. Build strong relationships and partnerships. It's important to create meaningful connections with your customers, your suppliers, and your industry peers. And these relationships can lead to opportunities that will benefit everyone involved. For instance, they foster loyalty, encourage referrals, and open doors to collaborations that can help your business grow. Take Jessie, for example. Jessie owns a small bakery and she wanted to expand her business. Now, she is passionate about baking and she knew that she needed to find a way to stand out. She started by reaching out to local coffee shops and event planners. And by forming partnerships for catering services and joint promotions, Jessie increased her bakery's visibility. These collaborations brought in new customers through referrals and shared marketing efforts. And by nurturing these relationships, Jessie won more loyal customers and found a new way to scale her bakery. Yes, all you need to do is to just look around you. Trust me, there are business owners who are also looking for businesses to collaborate with. Now that that's cleared, let's move on to tip number 4, which is to prioritize customer experience. You can focus on delivering exceptional customer service and personalized experiences to build loyalty and encourage repeat businesses. Now here's why this matters. Satisfied customers become advocates for your brand, driving organic growth through positive word of mouth. Just like Olivia, for example. She's a mentee who owns an online skincare store. and she discovered that customer satisfaction was the key in the competitive e-commerce industry. Olivia invested in a user-friendly website, responsive customer support, and personalized product recommendations that are based on what her customers liked. Now, these efforts really paid off. Not only did sales go up, but her customers also started coming back for more and leaving positive reviews. Now, Olivia's focus on customer experience strengthened brand loyalty and fueled organic growth for her. Her story shows that exceptional service can drive business success. And yes, you don't need a huge amount of money to make that happen. For our last tip on this topic, let's have tip number 5, which is to invest in continuous learning and development. Make sure to allocate resources for ongoing education, skills development, and of course, market research, because this will help you stay competitive and innovative. Continuous learning will allow you to adapt to market changes, to refine your business strategies, and to seize any growth opportunities out there. Now, let me tell you about Marinel, who is a solopreneur in the fitness industry. Marinel is passionate about fitness training, but she faced challenges in expanding her clientele and diversifying her services. So, to overcome this, Marinel attended webinars, online courses, workshops, and industry conferences. She kept herself updated on fitness trends, nutrition research, and client engagement strategies. Now, this commitment to continuous learning finally paid off. Marinel enhanced her training programs, attracted new clients with specialized services, and she was able to establish herself as a reputable fitness expert. To conclude, growing your business on a limited budget can be challenging but not impossible. With strategic planning, creativity, and dedication, you can overcome financial constraints and achieve sustainable growth. So remember, every small step forward contributes to the success of your entrepreneurial journey. And if you're ready to learn more and to take your business to the next level, remember to subscribe to my newsletter and my free starter kit at mommynegosyo.com for more insights and tips. Thank you for joining me today. This is Mommy and your Mommy Negosyo saying, be business-minded, Pinoy!